I first got involved in Friendship Circle almost 20 years ago. It was something that a lot of kids in Kushner were doing at the time, and my parents encouraged me to get involved, and I was very excited about it. The Friendship Circle began to strike home 8 years ago when our daughter Batya was born, and she had cerebral palsy.
When Batya was born, we were very optimistic. We didn't know anything, and we were scared out of our minds. We said, what do we do? Knowing that they were a phone call away, not too far away either, we felt comforted by that.
They were here for us. They sent volunteers to our home. They sent volunteers to the hospital to be with her when we couldn't be with her. When someone from the Friendship Circle would walk in the door, it was like this big giant hug. It was like this big ball of comfort that made you feel like you can do this, you can get through this, you guys are gonna be okay. The night that Batya passed away, the Friendship Circle were there in a heartbeat. They were at the hospital with us, you know, when everything was happening. That was the most meaningful part to me, because that's where the Friendship Circle came around, you know, full circle, if you want to say, where we were on the receiving end. We started Team Batya about 8 years ago for the Friendship Circle, when we started walking with our team. Every year we have, you know, between 50 and 100 people show up and join us and walk in her memory. I would want people to remember Batya as the girl who brought so many people together in prayer, in unity, and here for the Friendship Circle. You know, when we get together that one Sunday a year and everyone comes out, that's for Batya. Our team walks for Batya.
I would like people to remember Batya as a gift, someone who reminds us that we have to be happy with what we have, to give a gift by your time or your money to the special needs community.
When I see a parent going through what we went through, we want to be there for them. We want them to know that the Friendship Circle is here for them, that we are here for them, and that the special needs community in general is here for them.
If I had a message for our friends, I would encourage them to open up your heart. Find it somewhere inside of yourself to give that piece of yourself to an organization that needs you.
The more people that know, the more people that are in the know, the more people that can come out and stand up and volunteer and give even an hour of their time would mean everything to the Friendship Circle.